Hello everyone, today I would like to show how I can apply machine learning to the stock market. So basically what I'm going to do today is I'm going to use technical analysis and combine it with the adjusted close price to predict the percentage change of a particular stock price 10 days in the future. So to start off, we need to import some important libraries. I would say some of the libraries are import pandas as PD, and we import YFinance as YF, and I also need to import NumPy as NP. So in this particular tutorial, we will be using Microsoft. So the symbol for Microsoft is MSFT, and we will download all the financial stock data using YF.download. We need to put in the symbols MSFT, let the progress be false. Our start date will be January 1st, 2018, and the end date will be June 1st, 2020. So if you look at the data frame for Microsoft, you'll see that we have a few columns. They are date, open, high, low, close, adjusted close, and volume. So how do we get the price of the stock 10 days in the future? We can actually do that by using dot shift minus 10. So basically what dot shift minus 10 does is dot shift minus 10 will shift a particular row to 10 rows behind. So what this means is that it will shift, let's say a particular row is at row 10, and dot shift minus 10 will minus 10 rows from row 10. So you end up in row 0. So we'll replicate the adjusted close in the price 10 days later. And with the help of dot shift minus 10, we will shift the row from, for example, row 10 to row 0. We can show this example more clearly by using msft.tail. Bracket 20. So what this shows is that it shows the last 20 rows of a data frame. So in my case, it will be the last 20 days of my data frame. As you can see, the last 10 rows is actually all NAN, which stands for not a number. This is because we only are using until June 1st, 2020. So for example, if you look at 29 May, 2020, you'll see that the adjusted close price is the same as the price 10 days later, 14 May 2020. With the column name price 10 days later, we'll create another column. And this column is very important as it will be the label or the output of our machine learning. The label is something that our machine learning will be trying to predict. So this time round, we'll be using MSFT bracket price 10 days later bracket dot percentage change bracket 10. So what we are doing here is we are comparing the price 10 days later with the adjusted close price to find out the percentage change between the 10 days. Now let's create another set of features. These features we are going to be using is the technical analysis. So now we'll import all the technical analysis library. We'll import TALIB, which stands for technical analysis library. So if you do not have this library, please do go pip install it. So we will be mainly using two particular technical analysis. They are the moving average as well as momentum. So momentum is more of tracking the rate of change of the price. So with the rate of change of price, it can determine the strength of a particular trend, the uptrend or the downtrend. Moving average is just taking the average of the price over a particular period of time. So let our time period be equals to 14 And let's try another set of technical analysis and let the time period be 7. So for those that are with 14 days, I will name it MA14 or MOM14. And those with time period equals to 7, I will have it as MA7 and MOM7. So basically, in such a case, I actually created another 4 columns. I would end my tutorial here. But in my next tutorial, I'm going to talk more about exploratory analysis. Do let me know if you have any questions. If not, see you next time.